why Giant FM moose in a little bit early as we are set for the Woodlawn Hospital report. I've been informed that John Alley was sick yesterday, so he sent CFO John Kraft to join us this morning. How you doing, sir?
Very good, thank you.
And you guys had a meeting yesterday.
We did. We had a board meeting yesterday. It was actually pretty short board meeting. I think we got through a couple of things in a hurry. Probably the only two things that were being discussed, we need to do some capital improvements on our central processing unit, the unit that sterilizes all the surgical equipment in anticipation of the Da Vinci that everybody's been hearing about that we're going to have. We're going to spend about $300,000 to get that area ready. We got some new sinks, sterilizing equipment, that type of stuff. So we're going to get that done by the end of March in anticipation for the delivery of the unit.
Okay, and I know you said end of March, so are they thinking first part of April for that unit to arrive?
It's supposed to be scheduled now for March 31st.
Okay.
We're anticipating it on March 31st. Obviously, there may be delays, but that's the date that we've got right now from Intuitive.
Okay. So what all else did you guys talk about at the board meeting?
Not very much. We went over some of the quality information that we give to the board every month, and then of course we went over the financials. We go over the financials every month, and for the month of January, had a pretty good month. We had gross revenues of $13.2 million. We had deductions of $8.4 million, so about 63%, which is a little bit more than what it was last year, but we had a price increase at the beginning of the year. So net revenues of $4.8 million. Other operating revenues of just under $100,000, so we had operating revenues of $4.9 million. We only had expenses of $4.6 million, so we actually had an operating profit of $279,000, and then when you add in some other non-operating revenues of $223,000, we had just over $500,000 profit for January. Good start for the year.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely better than being down for the start of the year, because that's never a good thing.
Absolutely. Yeah, I think board members are requesting that we have that for February, March, April, keep going on. But
oh, of course, they're ready for you guys to stay in that positive realm.
Yes, yes.
So we're all set, or in the process of getting set for the new Da Vinci equipment?
Yes, we are. That should be, it keeps us on the front edge of technology. It's going to be better for the patients. Their recovery times will be a lot quicker. Everybody's getting ready for it. It's a little bit of change that's going on because it's a little bit different than what we're used to, but everybody's getting very excited about the delivery of the equipment and then the use of the equipment.
Now, for those of the listeners that don't know, like myself, exactly what is the Da Vinci machine that you guys are getting?
Okay. The Da Vinci machine is a robotic machine where the it's kind of like laparoscopic surgery, except when they make the little incisions to put in the laparoscopic equipment, these are a set of arms that go in there, and then the surgeon actually operates from what looks like a cockpit, and he actually operates it remotely from another station. It's much more precise than laparoscopic equipment. Laparoscopic equipment, you see things in 2D, whereas on the Da Vinci, they see it in 3D. So they see a lot more. They have an extra arm in there where they can kind of move things out of the way if they need to do that. And then the little claws that they have are much more precise getting some of the stuff done. It does have cauterizing equipment so that it can shut off blood vessels as soon as they cut into them. So it's supposed to cut down a little bit on the time, but more impressively, it cuts down on the recovery time. People are almost recovered in a couple of hours rather than staying overnight or something like that. So it's much more precise.
Yeah. Definitely sounds like something that'll keep Woodlawn having all that technology.
Yes, yes. This is kind of a pretty large investment that we're that we're putting into it, but we're looking towards the future too, because we think that this type of surgery is going to be more and more common throughout the nation. I mean, the bigger hospitals already have this type of technology, so for us to have this technology is pretty exciting.
And I know Mr. Ali and I have talked in the past. You guys are getting a new heating and cooling system. Is there any updates on that, or are we still looking first part of spring for that?
I think we're still looking for the first part of spring. I think that's kind of been put on hold until we can get all this stuff done around the robotic surgery machine done, because we have to, like I said, we have to rearrange the central processing unit. It's a pretty big project to get that done, and then we have to do the training for the equipment once it comes in. So we've kind of put some of that on hold until we can get the equipment in and get it going.
Okay. Now, I know you said you're scheduled for delivery March 31st.
Correct.
When will the Da Vinci equipment officially be online and ready to be used?
Probably will take a week or so to get it set up, to get it everything, make sure everything's done. For the sterilization of the equipment that the machine uses, it's a little bit different than what we've been utilizing before, so it'll take a little bit of time to get everything ready. I'd expect by the second week of April, we'll be going.
Okay, so it definitely isn't a plug-and-play type of machine.
No, it's kind of interesting because it's as close as you can get considering the technology that's there. We had a demo unit in already, and they had computer simulations on there, and you could actually operate the equipment, and it's kind of amazing how easy it is to use considering you're talking about surgery and stuff. So it's not quite plug and play, but it's definitely pretty easy to learn. So the process for learning for the physicians probably all in all will take, we already have one that's been using it for quite a long time, but others, it'll only take a couple months for them to get up and running on it.
Awesome. Sounds like it's going to be definitely exactly what Woodlawn needs.
It does.
All right. Well, Mr. Kraft, thank you very much for stopping by.
Thank you.
Thanks for filling in for Mr. Ali, and hopefully he gets feeling better. And we look forward to seeing him or yourself again next month.
Sounds good. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, and have a safe afternoon. The snow decided to try to come down out of the blue.
We do have some weather today.
Yeah, the stuff that was supposed to be here last night, I guess it said, no, we're going to do it tomorrow, and arrive today.
Yes, it did.
So at least the kids got to go to school today. That's always the positive thing.
Or at least most of them did.
Yes, yeah, there were a few that delayed or canceled, but
right.
The Rochester kids are there.
They're so in school today.
My kids got to go to school today, and that's always a good thing.
Yes.
All right. Look forward to talking to you guys again next month. Again, this has been the Woodlawn Hospital Report. This month with CFO John Kraft. And now back to your regularly scheduled programming.